17 ways technology will change our lives by 2050. Where everyone is talking about the new forms of technology that are bound to change our lifestyles in just a few upcoming years, I can't help but think about how good our lives will be by 2050 with all this technology, technologies, and whatnot. Taking our homes, cities, and everyday house life, for example. We are already being told that there will be smart homes and buildings making up smart cities. All activities will be controlled by machines, robots will replace humans, and so on and so forth. Total iRobot case. This includes technologies like smart sensors, meters, processors, and IoT to help a smart city function as efficiently as they are meant to. They will help collect useful data and allows us to utilize the metrics for the implementation of better services. This is all part of the story. I am not denying it. But do we really know for sure that it will all dramatically impact our lives to make them more convenient? I don't think so. And not knowing isn't a problem presently, but it will be in the future to help you out. I want to give you an idea and draw a context. Have you ever thought your cutlery talking to you like, "Hey buddy, stop eating. You have had enough for lunch. Try eating after an hour maybe. Our cutlery bully us." If we start thinking and imagining about it presently, it will make us go crazy. Imagine thinking about all the things and objects that could talk like this. Spooky stuff though. But it's an inevitable reality and it can't be helped. And that's just the tip of the iceberg. There are a lot more exciting ways by which technology is and will be shaping our future in the year 2050. Now, let's move on to other forms of technology that will be completely incorporated into our lives, such as IoT, smart appliances, and the role of virtual reality in everyday menial tasks. Consider yourself a 9-to-5 office worker who is lazy like me and habitually gets late, also like me. With advancements in technology, even being lazy wouldn't be a problem anymore, although I'm not sure whether that would be a good thing for me or not. Your personal assistant like Alexa, Siri, Google Home will schedule your task for any given day. Your smart kitchen, also connected to the same personal assistant, will know your Monday's breakfast to cook. Using IoT, your smart refrigerator will order you fresh groceries, and your personal robot butler, such as being developed by Boston Dynamics, will present you with a delicious breakfast to have. We already have Rambas, so it's only uphill from there. Along with that, to get yourself prepared for your office, technology will have a lot of convenience coming your way with an easy-to-suit-up morning routine. For instance, say you have an important meeting today, so you want yourself to look presentable. Would you be trying every dress just to see which one looks best? Of course not. You can't waste time on each outfit, so what's the alternative? This is where virtual reality comes in handy. With virtual reality, you don't have to try on every dress you have. The technology will show you your looks virtually to help you decide which one will look best on that day. We already have Oculus Rift, then there are companies like Applier VR Lucid Sight, and many others making rapid developments in this domain. Not only this, but virtual reality is likely to replace textbooks, smartphones, and other devices by we reach 2050. Heck, we'll probably have that in the next 2 decades. But your day doesn't end here. Then there's the transport of the year 2050. The role of automation even in our office jobs, cloud technology, and advancements in technology that have already proven themselves promising. Here's some context. To get to your office tirelessly without driving yourself, your self-driving car will do the honor for you. As many researchers state, self-driving vehicles could be ubiquitous in the next 10 years. So we have that going for us, which may be nice. Autonomous vehicles are already under development from companies like Google. Even Apple is working on developing its own autonomous car. We have companies like Newtonomy, AutoX, Drive.ai, A-Ready, developing smart and intelligent public driving solutions, so it is quite likely we will see the first completely autonomous car on the streets real soon. If your vehicle's GPS finds traffic in your way, it will let you know earlier. Alternatively, you can opt to go to your location using flying taxis, just like those from The Simpsons. Seems a bit childish and nostalgic alike, but it will be true though. With technology, it will be. With advanced technology, traveling won't be limited to just around the globe. Even now, space trips are being designed to send people to Mars that are likely to start by 2030. Once you reach your office, you wouldn't have to bother yourselves to mark attendance, bring coffee, or turning things on. Automated systems having sensors integrated will assure your presence each day and start getting things ready for you accordingly. Many of our resources will be reduced to performing a single task. While robots could replace some workers, it's important to remember that past innovations have unlocked whole new industries and new jobs along with them. The rise of AI would do the same in every business. By 2050, cloud-based technologies will most likely integrate a ubiquitous stream of data, and the intelligent algorithms crunching will enable manufacturing lines to continuously optimize towards higher levels of output and product quality, while reducing overall waste in manufacturing by up to 50%. Statistics. Since architects around the globe have already been racing to build the world's first 3D printed house, 3D printing would be used to construct houses in the next 20 years or so. And this will again need human resources, means zero labor laws. And how can we forget about becoming cybernetically enhanced in the future? This will be made possible with the help of AI and the delivering technologies of the future. As opposed to some of the other trends discussed here, a digital twin is a technology that integrates artificial intelligence, machine learning, and software analytics to create a digital replica of physical assets that updates and changes as its physical counterpart changes. Digital twins provide a variety of information throughout an object's lifecycle and can even help when testing new functionalities of a physical object. Not trying to make things boring here for my viewers with the medical background looking for innovations in their domain. And if I'm not wrong, the medical field was the first side where AI proved its capabilities. Companies like Bionics are already developing bionic limbs, which are widespread and used by thousands of individuals on a daily basis. I know we are not here to talk about what AI has done for us till now, but yes, we are here to know that it will do for us in the future. Today, while evading COVID-19 and being cautious for health-related measures, we could start seeing delivery drones finally start making deliveries in the next 2 years. Amazon has the project under work as we speak. Regulation, rather than the technology, is more of a limiting factor for getting delivery drones off the ground. But researchers assume drones will be used to deliver things like packages to hospitals, but not everyday activities like pizza delivery. And now I want pizza. You too, right? Yay for us foodies! At the present, we can totally ruin our diet and whatnot. In the future, our AI-based assistant will most likely not let you do it. So keep that in mind. Moving on to the next innovation of the future, a globally perfect healthcare system along with telecom or cell phones of the future. Virtual immortality and potential into all the problems we face at the present. The healthcare paradigm is likely to shift to prevention through diet by 2025. Healthcare systems will adopt more preventative health approaches based on the developing science behind the health benefits of plant-rich, nutrient-dense diets. This trend will be enabled by AI systems and biology-based technology that exponentially grows our knowledge of the role of specific dietary phytonutrients in specific human health and functional outcomes. Additionally, a new norm of technology will emerge in how we can manage cancer. We will see more early and proactive screening with improved diagnostics innovation, such as in better genome sequencing technology or liquid biopsy, that promises higher ease of testing, higher accuracy, and ideally at an affordable cost. Early detection and intervention in common cancer types will not only save lives, but reduce the financial and emotional burden of late discovery. Companies like Remedy Medical, Unique, and Subtle Medical are already globally recognized for the development of smart, AI-rich solutions that can equip even non-trainer individuals with means of detecting and diagnosing chronic disease in their earlier stages. This employs the use of smart sensors and powerful equipment that can make it a breeze for patients to receive accurate diagnosis before it's too late. Last but not least, the smartphone will become obsolete by 2025. Shocked? You better believe it, folks. One of the researchers of Business Insider wrote that if it's 2025 and you have a smartphone, people will be laughing at you. And why not? When it is possible to pull up screens in AR via a tiny bracelet or another piece of jewelry in the next 10 years, carrying a smartphone is definitely going to become outdated, much like skin-tight jeans. Finally, humans could live forever as computerized brains. At the end of the day, if you feel exhausted, you can set your brain to live in a matrix-like virtual world by as early as 2045. Pearson, one of Tech Insider's researchers, said advancements in nanotechnology will make it possible to plug our brains into computers and live in a simulated world. We already have top brands like HTC, Samsung, LG, and Microsoft developing AR and VR-based solutions that can make it possible for us to enjoy a Matrix-like virtual world in coming few years. You can certainly make something a bit like the Matrix if you wanted to. By 2050, you could link people's brains to computers so much that they won't be able to differentiate real from virtual. In the end, I would say it is very exciting to see the pace and transformative potential of today's innovative technologies being applied to solve the world's most pressing problems, feeding a global growing population, improving access and quality of healthcare, and significantly reducing carbon emissions to address the downsides of climate change are the main reasons behind new technology trends. Summing up my words by wishing all the best of luck, as we may need it. To stay connected with the trends and technologies, stay connected to this channel.